Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Last winter, we did a range test for a NIO ET5 under extremely bad weather conditions. And this winter, we're going to do a range test for this NIO ET5 with a 75 kWh battery. And the trunk is pretty much, we filled up the trunk and with two passengers today. My cousin, Sarah, and the one holding the camera. Hey, Sarah.
Hey.
And we're going to do the range test for this NIO ET5. You know,
yeah. The
NIO ET5 has attracted lots of ladies' attention.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about this car?
I think this car is very gorgeous. The size is very suitable for girl. Mm-hmm. It's not very large. How do you say the pink one?
Oh yeah, the pink one is actually, it has a very romantic name. Mm-hmm. It calls a first light kiss.
Wow.
Will you buy this car?
Yeah, of course. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, I'm a fresh graduate. I don't have enough money to pay it.
Yeah, definitely you don't have enough budget to buy
this
one. So, Sarah, working harder and
okay.
Buy yourself one without asking your parents' help.
Yeah, I dreamed that day.
Yeah, that would be great.
There is a very heartwarming moment I'd like to share with you guys. On the day of the range test, I just accidentally cut my finger and the new stuff bandaged me very carefully as they were God's first aid kit. So why there is a NIO staff? It is because of the NIO's traveling service assurance plan during the spring festival, especially this year. According to NIO, in total 7,563 NIO staffs engaged into this plan. Very impressive, they provided nearly 200,000 times all kinds of NIO service during the Chinese New Year, including power express, driving service, roadside assistance, mobile maintenance, repair service, and so on. For example, on this service station, there is a supply station providing and giving help for NIO users. They provide many kinds of snacks and hot drinks. I think it's a very sweet service. You could feel the emotion connection with the NIO, and not just buyer-seller relationship. You probably couldn't find any other car makers doing like this. And it's also a very good marketing and advertising strategy as the NIO supply station was right next to the charging station. We got our battery swapped from the NIO power swap station, but it's around 93% for better battery health. So we have to charge our car to the 100% in the charging station. The place we are going is a small city with higher altitude than Hangzhou. The highest peak of Zhejiang province, Huangmaojian, is located in this city, but we are not going up to the mountain. So we drove from the plain area to the mountain and the hilly area. Therefore, it would consume more battery. It's definitely a real challenge for the ET5. The total travel distance is around 322 kilometers, which is 4 hours driving. And it shows 317 kilometers we will be able to use the NOP Plus, the automated navigation on highway. There is one very good feature of the map. It could show us all the charging facilities available on this route. And of course, we could choose only showing the battery swap station. As we can see from the map, it has 4 NIO power swap stations on this route, even in this small city. We adjust the AC to 24 degrees, as it's not a very cold day, and we put on the eco mode for longest range. On this test, we conducted 2 methods to find out the range performance of the ET5. For every 100 km actual travel distance, we record the CLTC range consumption and the electricity consumption per 100 km as well. When we merged to the highway, we got 555 km CLTC range remaining here. Then we activate the NOP Plus immediately. The way we're going to turn it on is by pressing the button there, which is the same as the NT1.0 models. The NOP is automated navigation on highway, which could follow the navigation to choose the farthest lane, overtake the cars, and take exit off the highway automatically. NIO ET5 is based on NT2.0 platform with LiDAR sensor and much higher autonomous driving ability, so they call it NOP Plus. The NOP Plus is getting more confident and smart when overtaking the vehicles if we compare with the NOP. I will share with you guys more detailed review in another video. After around 20 minutes driving, we were stuck on the traffic for a while because of the Chinese New Year. People are going back home for family reunion all over the country. It will definitely bring down the average speed of this trip as we spend 20 or 30 minutes just for a few kilometers. Most of the time, our car was driving at speed limits 100 km to 120 km an hour. As a result, the average speed of this trip is 90 km an hour, and it's still a relatively high speed as there are always low speed vehicles driving ahead on the highway. Alright guys, when we reach the 100 km travel distance, the CLTC range consumed 140 km, so the discounted rate is 71.4%, and the electricity consumption dropped from 19.3 kWh to the 18 kWh. Alright, about 30 minutes we were driven 200 km travel distance. The CLTC consumption is 287 km, so the discounted rate is 69.7%. The electricity consumption for the recent 100 km seems getting lower, which is around 17.5 kWh. After another 100 km driving, the CLTC consumption is 444 km, so the discounted rate is 67.6%. The battery consumption increased 1 kWh to the 18.5 kWh. It is because we were getting close to the mountain and the hilly area, so it needs more power to drive the car. Finally, we arrived here. The total travel distance is about 318 km, and the CLTC consumption is 462 km. So the final discounted rate would be 68.8%. If we take it as a reference to figure out the total range of this 75 kWh battery, then the total estimated range would be around 385 km under these kind of nearly fully loaded conditions. The electricity consumption has dropped again, which is around 17.1 kWh. From the electricity consumption distribution, we can see the autonomous driving used some part of the energy, but it's not a very large portion. The AC and music consumed 3% respectively. The total battery consumed on this trip is 56.8 kWh with 318 km actual travel distance. Then we could figure out the average electricity consumption per 100 km is 17.86 kWh. If we take it as a reference to work out the total estimated range of this 75 kWh battery, then very surprisingly, we got this number. 420 kilometers, and it is heavy performance. Based on the changes of the electricity consumption on this trip, if you drive on the plain area without much people and loads, then the performance could be better. The range performance really depends on weather conditions, the size of the wheels, the pressure of the tires, driver's behaviors, and how much things you fit into the car. So what do you guys think? Please leave your comment below if you have any thoughts. Alright guys, we will share with you guys more about NOP Plus in next video. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel and hit the bell. Thanks for watching today.